If you're still putting regular white cocaine up your nose, you're basically living in the 90s. From Medellin's elite clubbers to the cartel queens that run the underworld here, everyone who's anyone in Colombia right now is snorting pink cocaine, also known as tucibi.
El tucibi acá en Medellín es más importante que la coca.
It's fashionable, it's 6 times as expensive as regular white cocaine, it has its own genre of music, and it's so popular that it's even spawned a whole new generation of narcos.
La fiesta depende del tucibi, el tucibi depende de la fiesta.
Tucibi is taking over Colombia, and the word is that cartels here are expanding to Europe. They've set up labs in Spain. So if you haven't seen it already, expect to see it in Ibiza this season. Well, no. Although it is pink, it most certainly isn't cocaine. In fact, very few people who take this drug have any idea what's really in it. The confusing thing is that the word tucibi is kind of like a Latinization of tucibi, a psychedelic phenethylamine invented by Alexander Shulgin in the 1970s that feels a bit like LSD mixed with MDMA, lasts 2 to 3 hours, and was famously referenced on the Kanye track Yikes. But in Colombia, 95% of samples have shown that tucibi here contains no tucibi. So it's kind of just like, what is this drug?
To try to find out, we're gonna go hang out with some people who actually use it.
Kim Zuluaga is kind of a trans icon in Colombia, and her so-called butterflies have a huge social media following. They're also Guaracha DJs, and Guaracha is this kind of psychedelic reggaeton style music that's heavily influenced by tucibi.
Hoy tenemos una rumba de guaracha y vamos a ir a ligeras. Cuando uno consume tusi y está en una fiesta de guaracha o escucha guaracha, los sonidos de la guaracha están diseñados para que cuando uno esté drogada con el tusi, la mente alucine y sienta como muchas más sensaciones. Creo que es como una combinación de muchas drogas sintéticas en polvo. Pero pues en sí no, nosotras no sabemos qué. Y el tusi te da sensaciones mejores que la coca. La coca está pasada de moda, porque el tusi te hace sentir feliz. La mayoría de los jóvenes se están inclinando más por el tusi.
Oh, I thought that was makeup.
Hace parte de nosotras antes de salir, pues nos gusta darnos unos cuantos pasecitos para entrar en ambiente. ¿Quieres?
No, gracias. How does the tucibi feel?
Como una muñeca de cera derretida, pues no sé, algo tan. Porque hay veces que le echan mucho LSD.
After several bumps of tusi, Kim took us to a guaracha club where she was booked to DJ. The large groups of people getting into toilet cubicles together, pink rings on nostrils, and cheerful silliness made it apparent that most people here were on tusi.
Kim just disappeared and left me at the club, so we've head outside to just ask some random people what they think about tucibi. How popular is tucibi in Medellin?
O sea, realmente, o sea, realmente se ve demasiado. O sea, es como en cualquier parte llega alguien y te ofrece tucibi.
Why is it so popular in Medellin?
No sé, yo pienso que toda la narcocultura.
Es fácil de conseguir.
And what do you think is in tucibi?
Like,
yeah, what's it made of? Yeah.
Well, what I heard is like made of MDMA, some colorant and
A lot of shit.
A lot of random shit.
Yes.
Is it like an upper class drug or like a lower class drug? What would you say?
Okay. I think it doesn't discriminate, yeah. See? It doesn't discriminate.
Okay.
I get offered a lot.
So this magical pink powder may have injected a nice, colorful dose of psychedelia into Medellin's nightlife, but what's not so colorful are the violent narcos that actually make it and sell it. And there's one organization in particular called La Empresa, or The Enterprise, who've given us access to their operations. And they've become so rich from selling this trendy new drug that people are starting to call them neo-narcos.
To avoid putting all their drugs in one basket, The Enterprise has hundreds of smaller safe houses scattered throughout the neighborhood and connected by tunnels. These safe houses are manned by guards who protect and distribute the drugs to drivers.
There's a police drone right there, too.
Okay, what is it about?
The Enterprise are a new street gang in Medellin who get their drugs and their orders from the paramilitaries in the jungle. They control over half of Medellin and claim to be the first ones to make and sell tucibi.
Within the organization you work for, is tucibi one of the biggest earners for you?
En ese momento tenemos el ingreso más grande en tucibi en Medellín.
Have you seen these packets?
Tucibi. Son las papeletas más caras.
Ah, Rick and Morty. ¿Cuántas cuesta?
Esas las tenemos en el poblado, podemos costar 200, 300 mil pesos.
Okay.
Depende de la zona que tenemos distribuida.
So it's more expensive than cocaine?
Sí.
What do you actually put in tucibi?
Tenemos metanfetaminas, todo sintético. ¿Qué creen ahí? LSD.
So it's just a mix of pretty much every drug under the sun?
Sí, porque es más fuerte.
The original 2CB has no connection to this anymore. I think this is a totally different drug. Can I ask, do you ever put fentanyl in it?
Fentanelo, sí. Tienen fentanelo. Algunas personas le hace daño, pero nosotros tenemos que vender.
Okay, and the automatic weapons, are they mainly for other gangs or are they for the police?
Nos estamos cuidando de todo. En ese momento tenemos dos drones que nos están vigilando.
Is it normal to have drones watching your safe house?
No, no es normal. Sabemos que nos están respirando la nuca en ese momento. No nos podemos demorar. Tenemos caletas mayores, tenemos túneles, nosotros podemos salir por todos los lados, pero no podemos mostrar todo.
Okay.
¿Qué hora es? No sabemos si... Sí, sí.
Okay, well look, you've got two police drones looking at you right now, so... Muchas gracias. Gracias.
Bien, la prueba. Ten.
Do you need any more shots of the, have you got?
He says that we have to try.
Para ver la calidad.
Pero está bien.
Oh. No, gracias. No, gracias, no, gracias. No, 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 gracias. Okay, I'll try a little bit. Is this the one with fentanyl in it?
Poco.
Okay.
Poco. Dale, dale. Eso. Es poco, es poco.
Fentanyl is 100 times stronger than heroin, and even trace amounts can be deadly.
Cool. Yeah, so I really didn't want to try that, but when someone has a gun and they're pointing at you, I feel like it's safer to just risk it and pray that it doesn't have fentanyl in it. And we gotta get out of here soon because it's a pretty dangerous neighborhood, but it appears that 2CB doesn't actually have 2CB in it. It's just kind of like a dirty concoction mixed together by cartels to make money with pink dye thrown in. In the best case scenario, you're probably getting MDMA, ketamine, maybe some GHB, some other synthetics. In the worst case scenario, you're getting fentanyl.
I'm feeling a bit trippy, a bit euphoric, a bit dissociative, and a bit stimulant-y. After passing their test by trying their 2C, the Enterprise decided they trusted me enough to see another part of their operation and sent a driver to take me there.
Hey, man! Welcome to my car, man!
Thank you.
Voy a hacer alguna entreguita y todo, pero... Tadam! En este momento lo que le gusta a la gente, ven. Esto es una mina de oro, papá. Es número uno, como le cuento, entre los jóvenes. El tucibi, ven, es algo muy expropiado que llegó a todo el mundo, hermano, y que te juro que va a quedar por mucho rato.
All right, we'll leave you to carry on peddling tucibi around Medellin tonight. Good luck.
Yeah, man.
Okay, so apparently the enterprise have decided that they like us after that last interview, and they're letting us go see the actual cookhouse where they make tucibi. So we get to see how they actually make it and what they actually put in it.
Un pitazo y una trova. A mí pues me pone play. Y a ustedes pues aquí están viendo. Ahí producir cocaine. Se vino desde la USA y no le pidieron visa. Y aquí pues lo recibimos con 12 B y una sonrisa.
What are you guys doing right now?
Es preparaciones 12 B.
Okay, can you just explain to me how you make it, what you put in it, what are the ingredients?
MDM, la éxtasis, oxicodona clorhidrato, eso es la ketamina.
Okay.
Tenemos colorantes tipo 3.
Why do you put MDMA and ecstasy?
Para dar un producto mucho más efectivo. Estamos sacando la mejor calidad de Colombia.
What's this?
It's crack.
Does this go in the 2CB?
No. Este es mío.
Oh, you just like crack, okay.
Estos son los míos. Manos a la obra.
How much is all of this 2C worth?
De 400 a 420 gramos. Un gramo es un punto. Un punto cuesta entre 40 y 60 mil pesos colombianos.
This is a ton of money right here. So do you ever put anything else in it? I mean, we've heard of things like fentanyl going in, synthetic drugs.
Todo depende del cocinero y la receta que se tenga. Entonces muchas veces hacemos estas cosas no porque queramos, sino porque de verdad toca. A muchos no nos gusta estar acá, pero la vida nos pone en estas situaciones.
Have you ever thought that it might save you a lot of time if you invested in one of those baking mixers?
No.
Mixing together different drugs can sometimes be fine, but sometimes, like with the oxycodone and ketamine going into this batch, deadly. And that's one of the dangers of 2CB.
Ya quedaría lista para el consumo. ¡Ay, ay, ay!
The more time we spent with the enterprise, the more we began to realize that this pink-branded product they've created might be the most successful innovation in drugs since cocaine itself. And behind it all is one mastermind. Finally, we had become trusted enough to meet the head of their organization and the inventor of 2CB herself.
At the top of their organization is a woman called the Queen of Tusi. And she's earning around $20 million per year in revenue from selling 2CB. To interview her, we've had to get permission from, and she's had to get permission from the heads of the largest drug trafficking organization in the world, the Clan del Golfo. So that's where we're headed right now. Going to the right. The Queen of Tusi is one of the most wanted people in Medellin, so she's always changing her address and moving from safe house to safe house to safe house. So we don't know until the last second where we're actually gonna meet her. She's just told us to go to a lay-by and wait for her call. Hola? Okay, that's her. We gotta go. Okay, so all of a sudden we're being escorted by two Toyota Land Cruisers and two motorcycles, literally right in front of us and right behind us. This is the Queen of Tusi's security. So we're just gonna follow them now to her safe house. I'm pretty sure the person we're about to interview is a bigger deal than we even realized. We've just made it to the finca where the Tusi queen is currently hiding out, and we're gonna go interview her. It's a very nice house. This is like a proper narco pad. She is a little bit annoyed at us though, because we're late, so we got a little lost on the way, so hopefully she's not too angry, because I mean, she has had many people killed before, so she's probably gonna be hopefully friendly to us. Hola. It's a very beautiful house. Okay. So, why do they call you the Tusi Queen?
La coca tenía demasiada competencia. El Tusi apenas estaba empezando cuando yo viajé al exterior y traje la receta. Vi al principio que era muy rentable y fui creciendo. Desde la guaracha, las fiestas fuertes van unidas con el consumo. Indudablemente. Esto es para los jóvenes que quieren durar 3 o 4 días sin dormir.
How much money do you handle per week?
Por día entre 30 y 50 millones de pesos.
Have you ever had to use violence to defend your turf?
Total. Llevo 12 años y he pasado por mucha gente para llegar donde estoy. No se puede dejar enemigos sueltos. Hay un problema, hay que cortarlo de raíz. Mi antes jefe hizo algo indebido y yo le dije al jefe y ahí ya ocupé yo ese puesto.
Does it ever weigh on your conscience?
El primer mes, el primer tiempo de jazz, pues ya no. O sea, no tiene nada que ver.
And what kinds of things do you have to do to evade the police, the military, the DEA?
Todos se saben, se paga y se sigue, no más. Desde que tenga el dinero, no tiene problema de nada.
It's just as simple as that, you just pay them.
Right. Toda persona tiene un precio. Y si no lo tiene, lo solucionamos.
Is it true that cartels like yours are expanding Tusi production into Europe?
Sí.
Really?
Sí. Ya no es solamente Colombia. Nuestro cliente es los Estados Unidos. Ese es nuestro verdadero cliente.
The product you've created, this pink powder, it's not really tucibi. It's kind of a mix of lots of other random drugs, isn't it? So is it a way to kind of make a lot of money off of a cheap mixture of leftover drugs, basically?
Sí. Es una mezcla y, o sea, no es el propio tucibi, no, jamás.
Is it all basically just a very clever marketing ploy?
Sí.
It is.
Es claro.
It's a very clever way to make a drug more marketable by giving it a distinct color.
Parece inofensivo. El color rosado parece inofensivo. Es lo que más atrae, pues, a la persona.
Have you tried it before? Have any of you tried it before?
Nosotros no consumimos. Sabemos el daño que produce en el sistema nervioso central. Pues aquí lo que se logra es captar a la persona y dejarla ahí para que sea nuestro cliente potencial. Nosotros no vamos porque que le esté pasando algo a su familia, a su casa, no. Nosotros simplemente vendemos, ellos verán si consumen.
Hopefully the Europeans and the North Americans that the Tusi Queen is now selling to don't let the harmless pink coloring fool them. Her goal is to get you hooked.
People think that they decide what drugs they take, but they don't really. It's the narcos and the criminals who sell drugs that decide what drugs they take. And they've invented this bright pink powder. It doesn't really contain 2CB. It always contains some different cocktail of drugs. And it's just really their latest money-making scheme, and it's working. But despite that, it has had an indelible effect on Colombia's music, its nightlife. It's created a whole subculture.
In fact, now, tucibi in Colombia has begun to enter a strange new phase. Having dominated the mainstream, it's now having its craft beer moment. People are literally making their own personalized tucibi concoctions at home in a bizarre bastardization of what was already a bizarre bastardization of tucibi.
This is like really easy, you know? So this is the reason why everybody is doing this at home.
This is liquid ketamine?
Liquid ketamine, yeah, right.
Okay.
So we have in here 1 gram of MDMA. This is like 100 milligrams of ecstasy.
Yes. Okay.
and we take the liquid ecstasy.
Is it GHB?
Yeah, right.
Okay. So,
and we just need like a little bit of this colorant, cooking colorant. So I prefer to cook it myself and not to buy it, you know, because it could be dangerous. It smells good. It smells like cakes.
It smells like caramel.
Yeah.
What's that? What's that smell coming from?
From the colorant, because this is like bakery colorant. Perfect. So we got this. Now we can put it in here.
The final step. Okay, so yeah, now we have one bag of tucibi.
Yeah, voila.
It's crazy to think how many drugs are in that little pink package.
So I'm just gonna try a little bit. Yeah. Yeah, it tastes good.
How long will it take for you to feel the effects?
I think that it's like instantaneously, yes.
So right now you're feeling high on tucibi?
Yeah, I'm feeling high on tucibi, yes. Yeah, thank you.
Tucibi started as a euphoric psychedelic pill, but cartel marketing and a cultural movement have turned it into a Frankenstein drug. The only aspect of tucibi that you can ever really be sure of is that it's pink. And while it might seem like a Colombian phenomenon, this version of tucibi has now found its way onto dealers' menus all across Europe. There, where users are used to the original drug, the dangers of snorting this chemical mishmash can't really be understated.